Oh.
Oh, I saw a prime fucking tweet. Where'd it go?
Hit us with that tweet.
Hit us with that dick.
I should probably check audio levels. Really hard right now.
Oh. E3 going down in history with the best of it. Oh, you liked it. You retweeted it. Look who's on stage at E3.
Oh, yeah?
Then your girl.
So, Brian, let's review our predictions.
What's my prediction again?
Your predictions for Square Enix are Kingdom Hearts 3 Queens of DLC detail, Kingdom Hearts story so far on Switch, with 3 coming later, and Avengers is using MCU likenesses for, like, you know, those Dark Cap, not like fucking Daredevil.
Yeah.
Mine is that they end, well, I just have that they had announced somewhere Final Fantasy 16, Avengers gameplay release date, and a playable Wolverine, and a Tomb Raider reboot, which is my fucking Hail Mary, which is not going to happen.
I mean, you think with them showing off Final Fantasy 7, they'll also show off another Final Fantasy?
Yes.
I just assume that the Final Fantasy team has been working on this.
There's always Final Fantasy.
I mean, that's what they're known for. That's what...
This is, you want to know something horrifying? This is the longest period of time we've had without knowing the next Final Fantasy.
Really?
Yes. And that's why I'm thinking that.
Yeah.
We already know about Avengers. We already know about this Final Fantasy.
We're streaming.
Yes, we're streaming.
Yay! Oh, I forgot.
That's why I said I'm starting to lie.
Well, good thing I didn't say anything stupid.
Have we ever had a Final Fantasy where you play as a girl? There was one, right?
Final Fantasy X-2.
That would have been a good prediction. We see a Final Fantasy 16 and you play as a girl.
I'll be totally down with that. And, you know, make it a good game, not a terrible game like X-2 was.
Wasn't there one where you play as a girl named Lightning? Some shit?
I haven't played a new Final Fantasy.
Imagine
in a
like
long
in this
time.
Imagine like you see someone get ejected.
what do you mean? It's almost America.
Can I say that I love that your one prediction that's come true is that Elder Scrolls Blades would go on for way too long.
You know what Elder Scrolls Blades is?
It's like their
mobile
game
that they really were hyping up that you can play vertically with one hand.
Just like swipe.
It took too long because they were showing it, and they also showed that you can play on Switch now.
What was that thing that we saw at whatever the Game Awards was, where it was like they had two guys who play a mobile game against each other and nobody cared?
No, I don't know what the fuck that was.
That's exactly how shitty it was.
Yeah, it's out of my mind. Oh, Yubi announced a shitty mobile game too.
Yeah, cool.
It's like using all the Tom Clancy properties, and it literally, the game looks so bad.
Did you see what Netflix announced today?
What?
Hold on.
Is it a Division movie?
Yeah.
Because they announced that during the conference.
That's probably,
They were like, there's a Division movie coming at a later date to Netflix. I was like, okay. Seems like a weird place to announce that.
Oh, yo, what the fuck was up with Rob Michelinie being there? My stream was cutting out.
He was debuting his new show.
On Apple TV.
Which it literally looks like Silicon Valley for video games. And it didn't look that hard. It looked okay. Like, I watched the trailer, I was like, this should be funny. Like, I am not impressed. It looked tight. But when I heard the sunny music,
I thought
it
was just a dude.
No, it was him. It was definitely him.
I just saw the thumbnail.
Yeah, no, it was dead ass him.
Well, real quick, I like how they now have the same video on a really shitty layout that looks like the frame. That's on stage. They could just show me the awesome fucking background they got going on.
Oh, they're gonna ruin this.
No, it's gonna be good. They're gonna open with fucking.
Welcome to Square Enix Live.
You think so?
Please take your seat.
You think
the show will begin
Fantasy?
In 5 minutes.
You know, curveball. I'm gonna get my Final Fantasy IX remake.
Can you imagine? Like, this remake isn't even out yet, but we're gonna announce the next one.
They're not going to do it ever, but if they were tonight announcing a Final Fantasy IX remake, it's my favorite game ever made. I will fucking, like, I might be in my pants right now. I'm actually doing a replay of it right now because I downloaded it off and downloaded my PlayStation. So. Got all those fancy thing. Yeah, change one.
Well, it's really hard to tell because their music was real low.
Yeah.
Their music's like blasting.
Let's just take Brian's channel. I'm the stream now.
I'm the stream boy. I'm the one who streams.
Ha 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 ha!
Hola.
Whoa.
Como esta, bitches?
Oh shit.
Oh shit. The empty chair.
Just move it, then.
Yeah, I think I might honestly just move it.
Over under on how long Brian lasts before he's like, I cuddle with the chair back.
I'm
saying 20 minutes. He makes it to 9:20, and he's like, I want the chair back.
There we go. Try to gossip, girls.
God damn, why does my fucking phone suck today?
You shouldn't stick it up your ass. So
I know,
often.
I'm sorry.
It's probably broken.
The signal finder's all clogged with my duty.
God.
Yes.
I hear if you stick it up your urethra, it cancels out the duty.
I did hear that.
Wait, what's this music?
I don't know, man. You couldn't tell by the picture frame that the
are
music wasn't going to be
top. Are they in a theater with, like, really intense, like, Disney orchestral music?
I like to imagine, like you said, they keep the frame for the entire thing. You just hear one guy in, like, the very back row, like, what the fuck is this?
I just hear a gunshot and a body be pulled
out. Whoa, too soon.
He's just like, oh, you gotta be fucking kidding me. I could've watched this from home.
That's probably really funny.
What?
They don't do video game stuff normally in this theater, right?
I would imagine not.
I bet whoever, like, owns this theater is like, what the fuck is going on tonight?
Yeah,
look at these out-of-focus
people
in
like
horrible lighting waving at the camera. Good job, Square.
I bet all the fucking employees are like, why are all these people in, like, jeans and t-shirts coming in here?
Welcome to Square Enix Live.
Shut up.
At this time, please remember to silence your cell phones and avoid any flash photography. Thank you. We'll begin shortly.
They just start playing the from the Aqua Teen movie.
It's all going to lie.
Don't pull your penis out unless you need to. Decent exposure is a class 3 felony.
Imagine, like, they have the guy from Square Enix come out in a fucking Iron Man suit. He starts flying around the
theater. Are we gonna see control?
Oh, like, it malfunctions. Oh, Jesus Christ!
Was Control a Square Enix game?
It was Remedy.
Who showed them last year? What conference were they at?
PlayStation.
PlayStation kind of made a smart move not showing up.
Yeah.
Xbox fucking sucked.
E3 was whelming.
They didn't show any fucking Gears gameplay and that shit went on for like 10 minutes.
You know what's weird though? As whelming as E3 was, 2020 is looking fucking insane.
Yeah.
Like,
they played a fucking like entire Billie Eilish song.
I could already see the game of the year heated discussions between Cyberpunk and Last of Us 2. Because you know that game's coming out in 2020.
Cyberpunk's still
in. Probably.
I feel like people are going to be wanting more of The Last of Us 1 and it's going to throw them for a loop and kind of be very different.
Yeah.
Not to mention, I feel like The Last of Us 2 is probably going to be a hard game.
Yeah.
Like,
probably.
I'm okay with that, honestly. Because I know Naughty Dog has never put out a bad game.
You're Naughty Dog.
I just can't wait for that motherfucking faction.
Dude, it's gonna go dark in here. Bum, bum, ba, bam, bam.
You're just gonna hear the Iron Man like, beeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeee You think they're opening with that or Final Fantasy VII?
I think Avengers. Let's go.
Sizzle reel. About how we as developers are united.
Oh god, you better not fucking show me this fucking frame all night.
Oh, thank god.
Is it going away?
Yeah.
The picture frame's floating away! Who did that? Who did that? Usually curtains look like
that. Oh, it's Final Fantasy.
Yeah.
Do they have a sword on stage or is it a big picture?
Oh,
it's
oh my
tight.
God.
If you died, we'd hit a new game. Why would you do that? They're gonna hit a new game.
It's gonna show me the opening sequence from Final Fantasy VII that I've seen the other time for playing the game.
We saw this the other day.
Guys, if I haven't played Final Fantasy 1 through 15, will I understand 7 Remake?
Oh man, spoiler alert!
The game's been out for 20 years.
Spoiler! I want to see more. Show him in the fucking dress. Show him in the dress.
Yeah, right? I want to see that scene. I want to see that scene.
They should have opened with just him in the dress being like...
Now they actually have to talk.
Yeah, he can talk. No,
please welcome Yoshinori Kitase.
Oh fuck, they got Yoshi?
Final Fantasy VII.
They fucking did it!
Should have predicted it.
All the Smash Legends are making appearances.
Everybody's here. Man, it's like, get off my fucking square, there's someone over there.
I'm very happy to be able to introduce this long beloved title once again. After 22 years, the familiar characters we love have returned while becoming more beautiful and captivating than ever before.
今まで応援し続けてくださってるファンの皆さん、長年のサポートありがとうございます。大変お待たせいたしました。新たなる冒険と共に進んだところを非常に楽しみにしております。
What's he gonna spit out an egg? We thank you for your support and patience over these years, and we look forward to embarking on this journey together.
FF7 をリメイクするにあたって、Final Fantasy VII の世界観やキャラクターたちをより深く今回は描いております。ファイナルファンタジー7リメイクプロジェクトの最初の作品となる本作ではミッドガルのストーリーを広大にかつ緻密に語っております。またゲームデザインも今作用に最適化しておりまして、ブルーレイ2枚組相当のボリュームを見込んでおります。
一
本の独立したゲームとして十分期待に応える作品になっております。
Remaking Final Fantasy VII has allowed us to dive much deeper into the world and its characters than ever before. The game design was optimized for this title as well, and we anticipate two Blu-ray discs worth of gameplay content.
You could all thank this man.
The first game in this project was built on the studio's Midgar. It is such an elaborate retelling that it has become a solid standalone game in its own right.
Two Blu-ray discs.
これからご紹介する映像およびゲームプレイで、まあ、ファンの方の、期待を決して裏切らない皆さんのね、よく知っているあの FF7 に再会できることとなります。
Through the content we're about to unveil today, and through all that we have yet to unveil, we will not disappoint your expectations.
If Midgar is the first level, then it's more than
you. Your reunion with the Final Fantasy VII you know is near.
まあ、それと同時にですね、当時を知らないゲームファンの方は、全く新しいね、ファイナルファンタジーと出会うことになります。
To newcomers who never played the original, we present to you a completely new Final Fantasy and a perfect starting point to explore the world of Final Fantasy VII.
Please welcome Neil Pabone, Senior Manager, Product Marketing, Square Enix.
Neil Pabone sounds like a guy that I'll be able to understand. Bring him out.
はい、本日はですね、ニールにゲームプレイを紹介してもらいます。
You had your turn, Yoshi.
To introduce you and walk you through gameplay.
Is he a Foo Fighter? Sure.
Yeah.
Thank you, Kitase-san.
Yo, Yoshi or Neil?
All right, everyone. Let's mosey. Final Fantasy VII Remake features a hybrid gameplay system that merges real-time action with strategic command-based combat. For starters,Each press of the square button is a swing of Cloud's Buster Sword. Cloud attacks, dodges, and blocks all in real time. His standard attacks do some damage, but they barely scratch the surface of Cloud's true potential. Succeeding on the battlefield requires much more than just hacking and slashing. Cloud needs to be tactical. He needs ATB. Two ATB bars are displayed in the lower right.These fill up slowly over time, but fill much faster as Cloud lands standard attacks. Once an ATB bar is full, you can enter tactical mode, where time slows to a crawl and you have the opportunity to choose actions from the command menu. Katase-san, I've had the pleasure of seeing quite a bit of the game, but tactical mode never gets old for me. I could just sit here all day long and watch this beautiful slow motion action.
観客の皆さんはね、おそらくね、他の部分ももう少し見たいのではないかと思いますが、皆さんいかがでしょう。
I think the audience would like to see more. Isn't that right, everyone?
Fair enough. Good point, good point.
Yeah.
Well, once in tactical mode, you can choose to perform various abilities, such as Cloud's Braver attack. Using an item in battle will deplete an ATB charge, and if Cloud has the right materia equipped and enough MP, he can use ATB charges to cast spells. Of course, this being a remake, we're sure to see some familiar faces. With the use of his iconic gun arm, Barret is able to target enemies at a distance. Barret's standard attacks generate ATB charges similar to Cloud, but his abilities are entirely different.
I'm so hyped.
Switching between characters in combat is done with a single button press, which makes rotating through party members a snap. Speaking of other party members, Katase-san, when are we going to see Tifa in action?
Maybe soon.
All right. Characters will continue to fight even when you're not controlling them directly, but it's up to you to choose how and when ATB charges are used. You can maximize your effectiveness by switching between characters or issuing commands to characters with full ATB bars. Every enemy has a focus gauge that fills up as you do damage. When the gauge is full, the enemy becomes staggered and you'll deal bonus damage. Tactical mode evokes the command selections from the original Final Fantasy VII and allows players to enjoy battle while taking the time to think strategically. For players who prefer fast-paced action, abilities and spells can be bound to shortcuts for immediate execution. Shortcuts make combat extremely dynamic, but the choice of using them is entirely up to you.
Right, Cloud can now summon Big Thunder Mountain Metal Road.
Is that a Simba charm?
The game is made so that you can choose how to play. Hope players get excited about this.
Ralph is now in Final Fantasy.
Well, that's a brief introduction to combat in Final Fantasy VII Remake, and we look forward to showing you a whole lot more in the coming months. For now, let's see how Cloud and Barret do against a more formidable foe.
Oh, is it going to be the boss in the first level? Or maybe your boy Sefi?
They're going to fight the Disney Corporation.
There we go, this part.
You double crossing!
Heads up.
What in the hell?
That's the first boss, right?
Yeah. Hey, how the hell do we fight this thing?
It's got reinforced armor plating.
I don't even have a minigun for a remote to figure out how to fight this thing.
How does he reload?
Yeah, where's the ammo for that?
He's got like a bandolier hanging in his pants.
He has to eat the bullets to reload it.
Nah, he's a bandolier hanging out his pants. Like toilet paper.
It's on you.
You don't want to know. I'm waiting. Oh, they make you puppets with some people.
Going all out.
This? Yeah.
Yeah.
Big white
hat
thing.
I know Red 13 is
gone. Meet him much later.
Yeah. We're probably thinking of Red 13.
A barrier? Never seen this defense system before.
What's that? Thought you were the expert!
See, this looks dope because it's just like in No, it's Mega Blocks!
Everything is awesome!
Hey, look, did you see that? Forza 4 got Lego expansion.
Take them down.
It's like the realistic cars racing aside, like Lego cars. In like Lego worlds, it's amazing.
Yo, your Cloud's limit up almost pretty wrecked.
Holy
somebody.
Balls!
Yo, punish mode. Punishers in this game?
Damn it. We
you up soon.
Bugs, it's not like a fucking, like, a bondage mask. It wasn't a whip, it's Punisher mode.
Did you see the crowd go, like, dead silent? Everybody gasps at one.
This one. Fuck all of it! Oh, yeah. Strike now. Fire and wild! Are you good for this character?
By the way, I'm trying to play through the game.
DLC. We're getting so much Final Fantasy gameplay right now. We're getting the first full boss.
Go, you got your limit. Use it, baby.
Here
it is. I also like educating the shit out of the boss.
Yeah.
They're saving the big ending at the limit now.
Dude, this is so good. You know what's funny? This is originally confirmed with Xbox and PS4. I think it's PS4.
Yeah. Is it really?
Yeah, I think they announced it last night. This one right here is for the planet. Limit! You fucking... Yeah, you know Barrett has that bang on him.
Barrett gets that motherfucking bang.
There we go. Okay,
going in.
I'm building up to it.
This really looks like Kingdom Hearts. Yeah. Like a puzzle.
Oh, baby.
Did you put 15 at all?
Not yet.
It's like it looked like it was gonna feel like Kingdom Hearts, and it didn't. But this looks like it's gonna kind of feel like Kingdom Hearts.
That's why I kind of fucked with it.
Yeah, because Kingdom Hearts is
like... Like, I can see myself playing it. Be the first Final Fantasy I've ever played.
These graphics are ridiculous.
Yeah, they really are.
Also, this is probably even the biggest game file ever.
What are we thinking? 80 gigs?
20 minutes.
I think we're
800. Dude, this is gonna take up the space that 2 Blu-ray discs.
Oh, fuck.
Red Dead wasn't even an entire Blu-ray disc.
Yeah.
It's probably close, I imagine.
You hear that? Damn thing showed you how it's done.
Come on, we gotta move. That's hype.
Please welcome Tetsuya Nomura, director, Final Fantasy VII Remake.
You guys have been standing there the whole time.
Thank you for joining us, Nomura-san. Yeah. It is an absolute honor to have you here.
I don't know if they like say, here. Like, oh, part
one. Katase-san, how do you feel working with Nomura-san once again on Final Fantasy VII Remake?
はい、彼とはですね、原作のFF7以降、まあ何作もね、一緒にね、その後も仕事はしてるんですけども、今作のね、2つにね、ディレクション、キャラクターというのをしてね、ストーリーとね、がっつり組むのはまた久しぶりなのでね、22年前と全く変わらない熱量でね、今作でも取り組んでる姿を見てね、私も正直ね、喜んでます。
Since the original Final Fantasy VII, I've worked with him on many titles, but it has been a while since we've actually had him work so heavily on a project like this, from the direction to character design to the story. And I'm really happy to see him working on this title with the same passion that he had 22 years ago.
I once caught Yoshi in the bathroom with my wife.
Can we turn off the subtitles?
I don't know why they're on.
今まであの結構長い間お待たせしましたが
I didn't turn them on. I guess it was like naturally turned on.
ありがとうございます。
Me too. Yeah.
そしてですね、皆さんあの今日初めてプレー画面を結構長めに見たと思いますが、おそらく想像してたものとは少し違ったんじゃないかなと思っています。
It's all headsets.
So first and foremost, we wanted to extend our gratitude to those who have been waiting so patiently and have been supporting us for such a long time until now.
Oh yeah, so we're bringing back the original composer.
Also, we've taken a look at gameplay right now, and we've fairly showed you a good.
He starts peeing on the ground.
No, me. I would pee everywhere.
No, but you're like, you're both peeing in
unison.
Like, he's peeing on the crowd, and you're remaking it with us sitting here. You know what I mean?
The background going on that video, that fire looks like dog shit.
And I was wondering, do you guys want to actually play the game?
I'm sure it looks fine in the game.
Yeah.
Well, maybe fire looks better. I don't know, maybe if subtitles were
in the game.
明日から開催されます E3 のですね、スクエアニックスブースの方で、セブンリメイク、プレイアブル出展していますので、ぜひ機会のある方は、触れてみてください。
Lamori, you can't say
that. So we actually have playable demo kiosks available at the Square Enix E3 booth. So I hope you have the opportunity to try it out.
これデモのキオスク。
はい。それではですね、最後に、皆さんにご覧いただきたいものがありますので、ぜひ、昨日はですね、コンサートの方でショート版のトレーラーを、公開しましたけども、今日はあのロング版をご用意してますので、ぜひご覧ください。
So finally, there is something that we wanted to show you. Yesterday we showed you a short version of a trailer at the Final Fantasy VII concert. Today we have a longer version.
それではお願いします。
All right, please take a look.
Just sit through a whole fucking song now.
But she's hot. Look at her.
Who's here for Avengers?
I'm here for cute anime girls.
Yeah, dude, Avengers. Iron Man's a cute anime girl.
Yeah.
One Blu-ray disc is this city,
which immediately gets annihilated 5 minutes into
the game. It just went district, right?
These sewer rats appear to call themselves Avalanche, sir.
Driving on these fucking bikes.
You can have it.
Remember that part?
My life.
That's keeper.
How is that fucking like dark vision?
You think he's a keeper?
Oh my God. It's so dark.
And it's part of the game. Yeah. Light-wise, though. That great shit.
Have you already saw this?
Y'all gotta look at the bigger picture here. Nothing worth fighting for was ever won without sacrifice.
Help me!
Have you been a
like,
good girl?
Like, all sorts of looks. We're like laying on the bed.
I heard you're having second thoughts.
I know we have to think big if we're going to make a difference. But not like this. I just...
Yo, eggs and chips?
I feel trapped.
It's a horrible thing.
All I know is, R/134 is getting the fucking pencils ready. They're ripping up the engines.
Rev up those priors. What was it that came out? Oh yeah, when they
announced... There we go, fuck yeah.
They announced the Pokemon game, and like, immediately, like, 5 minutes later, they started warming up.
Get going.
Anymore? That was like literally a thing though.
Oh fuck, that chocobo chick.
Oh fuck, the cactar.
Oh, that steelbook case.
Yeah, it's fucking hot. Not much in that fucking though.
They legitimately sent a motorcycle to your house.
You get a different motorcycle? I mean, I'm fine with the one that the game
I think
game.
It was a statue.
It's a statue, yeah.
Oh, a statue?
Yeah.
Oh, that's hot. Oh, why are you showing me this?
Life is Strange?
Yeah, why are you showing me this?
Let's go.
I changed my hair. I have a cool mohawk now.
Hey,
not this party, didn't.
Just the sun I wanted to see.
You keep your eyes closed.
I know what happened with you guys in Seattle.
Finish episode 10. You're fucking up, man.
Well, I might be spoiled right here.
How do you feel?
With us, misfits.
I gotta show the boobs again.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, you see her boobs too?
Ready when you are, young master.
Oh, fuck,
God.
I gotta get in there.
Told you you've been fucking up.
Oh, my gosh.
I love the setting. It's so beautiful, man.
Put the lobo.
Time to hit the road.
You'll be fine, Daniel, as long as we're together.
I want to see what his power can do.
Come on, Daniel. Seems
great.
You got this.
Starting to be able to control his power.
Oh,
gosh.
Oh, no.
No,
so
I shouldn't do this.
God, are you crazy?
Life is Strange 1 walks.
No.
Life is Strange 2 can run.
They just showed me when I was streaming.
Go
shit, TOS.
I miss Dad.
I'm so sorry.
I love her.
I'm really glad I got to meet you.
It's the same for me.
Ah, bro hug. What a nice dude, man.
And him. Boy, Brody. It's the puppy!
The puppy!
We got a puppy!
Those, like, reactions to people playing the game.
Yeah.
Daniel!
Really
come
serious.
On! Run!
It's all Tessie Bull control.
This is gonna be the cliffhanger.
That's so sad!
God damn it.
Stop, Daniel. I said stop!
Don't grab me!
That was so intense.
It's my power, not yours.
What the?
No.
That's the ending, isn't it?
This game is awesome.
Like, is this a commercial?
Yeah.
Whatever, if they want to pad it with some commercials, whatever. What the fuck is this?
It's the picture frames.
The picture frames literally didn't have photos in them. The photos were like following
game?
The frames.
Saints Row.
From ages long ago,
no.
Miasma has blanketed
the world. Dude, don't forget Saints 4 and them going back in time.
Deadly miasma in check.
And I don't think
the
Get Out of Hell's canon because there's like 7 different endings you can pick. And they're all jokes.
These are the chronicles of brave young adventurers.
Oh my god, they're remaking Final Fantasy Chronicles?
These are the Crystal Chronicles.
This looks like a
if we had no crystals, miasma would consume us all, correct?
Never did I imagine that it could be so bright.
I love her, that's me.
An online multiplayer
literally me.
Mode, caravan with friends
mobile?
Wherever
yeah.
you may be.
Mobile? Was the game multiplayer?
Keep the adventure close at hand. The journey now unfolds on smartphones.
Multiplayer didn't exist, really.
Final Fantasy Crystal Chronicles Remastered Edition. This winter, embark on a new
winter
journey once more.
Fuck Xbox!
The journey begins!
On the bed.
Oh, this is the game I want to hear from my Switch.
Lead us on our way. This should be fun.
It was basically trying to, like,
this
make a new turn-based series, but, like, being able to keep Final Fantasy away from that genre now.
Prepare
yeah.
yourself! I will not lose
I
to you!
I love the fucking art style.
It's
I
Final
love the
Fantasy
art style.
One art.
It just wasn't really for me.
Now the trueness of begins.
I played the demo.
Oh, you did the demo.
This is the beginning.
I just wasn't really feeling it.
Conjure lightning.
This was so.
Because I do love turn-based shit.
Protect those in need.
Get up to combat. Let's
end this, shall we?
My brand, I'll strike you down.
I'm ready for you.
This is our chance.
Octopath.
Travel.
So.
That was the
hype. Fuck you, Xbox! Saints Row.
What would you do for fun
something for her. She was like almost completely naked. Not much armor. I think there's gonna be like new stuff. This looks like another part.
What you're showing me is Final Fantasy and Avengers just padding the compass with commercials.
Nah, these are all big for the fans, I'm sure.
It'll be big Saints Row 5 right here.
Hey man, that's cool. And it's on the Switch.
See, it would have been cool if I said that.
I hear it and actually
went to Saints Row 5.
Anything on the Switch is good. I see a lot of purple in that one frame. I don't know, man.
Not a purple frame.
Not a purple frame. Imagine this music with Saints Row 5.
Dude. It's bigger! It's better!
You know they're gonna throw
it's the one, the only, the builders, builder of the game! It's Dragon Quest Builders 2!
I'm like low-key interested in this because isn't this like Minecraft with like...
The children of Hargon, the vile cult that worships destruction,
this looks
has outlawed the building, cooking, and creation of all things, and captured the builders. All hope seems to be lost until you, a young apprentice builder, manages to escape the clutches of evil.
That one guy? It's gonna be announced for Smash tomorrow.
Washed up on the deserted shores of the Isle of Awakening, and with the help of your spirited and mysterious companion, Malroth, it is up to you to doff your mallet and club, unravel the riddles of this land, and defeat the hateful children
kind
of Harkon. Becoming
like the Norman anime.
Right?
Like literally that style.
Diverse islands and discover your true potential as a master builder. There is a land of adventure with many islands offering unlimited building combinations.
Oh, he's a fisherman!
You will have to master new crafting skills on each island, with more to do and even more to create.
The fuck is
everything in Dragon Quest Builders 2 is much, much bigger! Build huge structures in a larger world with more variety and options than ever before. And with a little help from the eager islanders.
Now that's the second answer.
The world is humongous, and you'll need your wits about you to get around. Run across open fields and explore ruins, treacherous mines, and spectacular castles. Dive into the watery depths to discover hidden treasures. Climb the highest mountains to catch the sunset.
Jump off the cliff and end your life.
Rest up for your next of adventure.
Build the highest cliff and jump off of it.
But beware. Monsters roam this land and will
so
need
you
to be dispatched
of your
cunning composure. Luckily, accompanying
the citizens
you on your quest
town.
Is the enigmatic Malroth, an aggressive amnesiac with a fondness
Bill
for fighting foes. Use powerful attacks on the battlefield to take down monstrous beasts!
What did you call me?
Are those characters literally look like young Gohan?
Yeah.
Work together with your villagers to till soil, plant seeds, and raise a multitude of crops. Be sure to customize the way you build your fields to support the kind of crops you'll grow. Harvest anything from the humble cabbage and wheat to tantalizingly tasty tomatoes.
I was joking. I don't want
you don't?
I know, but like, I'm sick of it. Like,
big projects require big help.
A baby and a wife.
You and three friends can team up online to build anything you can imagine. Let your creativity run wild!
Oh, there's a fucking star.
The only limit is your imagination. So call on your friends and build your fate together.
Is this
online?
Alright, maybe I can see us having some fun with this.
The road you build is paved with peril, young builder. Only you can defeat the children of Hargon.
Is that the next Donkey Kong?
Bring an end to destruction. And
did
save
the
world Kazooie? In Dragon Quest Builders 2!
Fuck you, that's going to suck. Are these even like studios that like Sony owns or is Square does not put their show on Xbox? They don't
well,
wanna...
I place, well, Final Fantasy after Cartridge Days was always a PlayStation game.
I saw the fucking, I saw the Switch thing and I thought I was getting the fucking,
I was getting my Kingdom Hearts far.
Look at this.
Is it starting to move around?
Nervish, the Luminary.
Oh yeah, they spell like 8 years on this game.
And will bring
showing
misery to our realm. You shall not escape me, Darkspawn!
Oh, I didn't know this was from an 8-bit game.
Let's do this. I believe in you. I believe in the Luminary.
Here's the bird.
Yeah.
Final Fantasy 1!
I feel like they gotta commit to showing me like one Dragon Ball at the end of the time. Don't make me spend 10 hours watching them.
It's the Dragon Ball.
Yeah, you got the Dragon Balls. Cool.
Those were Infinity Stones, idiot.
No, those were the Chaos Emeralds.
No, those were the stones for Mario Tennis. Echoes of an Evolutive Age Definitive Edition S!
Turbo and Ultra Edition XD! 11x72.3 not ready when it was released.
Purple frame. Saints.
Let's Saints. Fucking go, come Saints. On. Come on, give it to me.
You didn't want Gosha?
Anyone, were you guys hyped for I Spy the Game? For a Square Enix racing game.
We're a family of motorsport fans from Mexico, and we're the founders of Original Fire
Square
Games.
Square Enix is making a Mexican race car game.
We have seen a fascinating evolution in racing games.
But
nowadays,
can
you can
I
drive almost any type of car on amazing creations of the best tracks
racing,
in the world.
Race car?
However, we believe it's time to try something different. We want to do this by reviving a style that pioneered racing games decades ago.
Our game mixes top-down
what
racing,
a shitty racing
with a classic
game, the Xbox only.
Where's Herbie? I want Herbie.
Oh, God. I mean,
which
Xbox
brings together a whole range of styles and eras of motorsport.
We are delighted to share this moment with you.
And show a sneak preview of our game, which Square Enix Collective will publish in 2020.
Join us for the next video again soon.
They really just don't like Xbox.
I'm saying, like, Xbox controllers are just kind of...
Oh, what the fuck is this? Imagine being like so heated at this game, like screaming at your TV.
So what you're saying is I shouldn't get this game. Yeah, really, yeah, okay.
Well, this is an indie, that's why it's coming out.
Battalion 1944 recaptures the core of classic competitive first-person shooters. You'll need to quickly coordinate strategies with your team on the fly, whilst keeping your movement nimble and your aim precise if you hope to beat out the competition. There are multiple game modes for you and your team to dive into. Test your skills in domination, capture the flag, or team deathmatch, and perfect your tactics in the highly competitive Wartide game mode. FaceIt's competitive toolset is fully integrated into the game, bringing world-renowned competitive matchmaking, 1v1s, tournaments, rankings, and leaderboards.
Bro, just give me Saints Row.
Kill
I don't
enemies,
give a fuck about
win matches and rank up to demonstrate your Battalion 1944 prowess and unlock visual customization rewards.
Right?
A couple of guys will buy this game out of nostalgia and no one's gonna really play it.
Each season,
there's been predictable experience right complete now.
And medals to unlock.
Oh, this is already
out. While tracking your in-game accomplishments and providing you with an easy way to compare them against your friends by in-game leaderboards. Halt the Axis offensive in their tracks with the Rapid Fire PPSH, or take fire with Pixel Precision with the Mosin Nagant, and a whole host of new weapons just as deadly as
their
own.
This looks like the Medal of Honor I played on the Wii.
Honestly, yeah.
And a variety of weapons at your disposal. Play as a team and compete to be top of the leaderboards.
What if Avengers is first person?
Available now on Steam.
Everyone's like, whoa.
Show me some purple motherfucker. There was another purple one. It was darker purple. Let's go. Fuck is. Oh. Okay.
That's not full.
Simple and cleaning.
Hey, Tifa. It's the barista. That's funny. Is there going to be a streaming thing where you can get, like, any music from any Square Enix game ever?
Yeah, it's called they can upload their fucking albums to Spotify.
Yeah, what the... what? It's better not be an app. Like a paid app. Okay, on streaming services.
It's not Spotify,
what is that? They say streaming services. I imagine that includes Spotify. It's like the biggest one.
I listen to video game music often.
You don't listen on Billy Billy?
You know I do. Here we go.
Is this the is the new Cars game? Is it Radiator Springs?
I don't think this will spoil anything for you, Luke, because I just don't know what's going on.
It's like the story after Goofy's fucking death. Looks like
because Donald missed the heel again.
Ever since Donald turned the gun on himself.
Yo, I'm trying to play his
fucking... Jesus Christ!
Yo, playing his fucking Reaper though, let's go. It's weird seeing Sora as a teammate. Dude, you get to play as dual bladed fucking your boy. Let me play as Axel though, let's go.
I feel like I played here already.
Yeah, that, I was like, what is this? I didn't like the silence at the first trailers, and I don't like it now.
It's weird to see DLC working in Hearts game.
I'm just gonna eliminate the need for a final mix.
Yeah. Rio Mine.
Gizdy.
Coming Please welcome Naoki Yoshida, producer Disney and director, Boss. Final Fantasy XIV Online.
I guess we can finish the first time.
Hi guys!
Hi guys, my name is Naoki Yoshida, producer and director
this is fake
of Final
Yoshi.
Fantasy XIV.
Oh, this Yoshi's crafting, all right?
He's
a phony.
I
met the real Yoshi.
I met the real Yoshi. 漆黒のヴィランズの紹介をさせていただきます。
So we'd like to take a little bit of your time to show off Shadowbringers Final Fantasy XIV's third expansion pack, which is releasing on July the 2nd.
Show me Avenger!
2013年に新生オルゼア R エルムリボーンが発売されてから6年が経ちました。なんと世界で累計登録アカウント数1600万を突破し、なんとこのですね、漆黒のヴィランズの発売を前にして、
有料会員数も過去最高を更新することができました。これらはすべて世界中のプレイヤー光の戦士の皆さんのおかげです。この場を借りて改めてお礼申し上げます。
It's been 6 years since the release of the Realm Reborn in 2013. Over the years we've surpassed 16 million total registered users.
Why, but I was like, you know what?
Plus, we've reached the highest number of active subscribers in history in its history before the launch of Shadowbringers. This is all thanks to our players, our Warriors of Light.
I would do it for like EA Play. It's a good time to test it. See if we last.
このシャドウブリンガーズではですね、拡張パッケージにとどまらない新作 RPG 一本分のボリュームとそしてゲーム体験をお届けしたいと思います。
We view Shadowbringers as more than a simple expansion pack, but as a new game filled with new, volume and gameplay experiences that are comparable to a brand new standalone RPG title.
また新ソムであるダンブレイカー、それから踊り子、新種目のロスガルとベーラなど、これからファイナルファンタジー14を始める皆さんにも多数の新規の要素が用意されています。
And there's so many new elements so in the game for those who have yet to play Final Fantasy XIV, including two new jobs, the Gunbreaker and the Dancer, as well as two new playable races, the Frothgar and the Viera.
ぜひ Final Fantasy シリーズの最新作として
Final Fantasy VII
リメイクの発売2020年3月3日までの間、漆黒のヴィランズをお楽しみください。
We are excited to bring Shadowbringers as the latest installment in the Final Fantasy franchise for our fans to enjoy at least until 2020 March 3rd when Final Fantasy VII Remake comes out.
それではいよいよ7月2日、ローンチとなりますが、この場で世界初公開となるその漆黒のヴィランズのローンチトレーラーをご覧いただきます。
We are pleased to bring a world premiere of the launch trailer for Shadowbringers releasing on July the 2nd.
Please take a look.
I want to just get the steelbook. I just want the steelbook.
I get it from the American.
No, this joke in the book.
And when, pray tell, did we last have a dark night?
Tom.
Over 100 bleeding years ago.
That's the game for that much money.
Oh shit, it's Satra! Space war
under the What Orange saw was the future.
That's how the Sin Eaters came to be. They were once living creatures, that were called to be part of the Flood. Once the change is born,
the eternal light of these creatures has confounded us for nigh on 100 years. But each we have put down, another has risen up in its place. Born of the self-same ether relinquished by its predecessor. That's Vorthry.
Sin Eaters are part of Yulmor society. But they must be fed with ether. Living ether.
This world is beyond saving. Like those who try to save it. This world has had its fill of heroes.
Dark Reed
Vision
of the
future is actually told me to switch the world because you can't read. I'm gonna be Cyberpunk John
Wick. Yo.
First we get Norman Reedus and the Funky Thieves, now we get Keanu Reeves and the Cyber Thieves.
Everything we did.
I love the internet.
Everything we gave. What was it for?
You know those Captain America movies where it's like, no, I don't think I will?
Yes.
I want to make one for Saints Row where it's like, do you want to appear at the Square Enix conference? They're like, no, I don't think I will. I'd say it's about the same. Because I think they're going to get a hefty deep dive into Avengers.
Waited for this moment.
It's coming out this year.
It's going to be like, alright, thanks for coming. Oh, by the way, we're coming out of the Avengers. Bye!
And?
It's like, what is it? Nick Willie, this one goes out to all my weeaboo freaks out there.
Through prayer and sacrifice. The will of the star was made manifest.
Sorry, I can only assume I misheard, but it sounded an awful lot like you were implying both Zodiac and Heidelin are not gods. But
they are gods after a fashion, yes. The eldest and most powerful of primals.
Idiot.
Yeah, look how nobody cares.
Yeah, people are just waiting for good shit. Not that.
Square, what the fuck are you doing?
And the stream's dead.
Dying Light?
Maybe. Yeah, it might be Dying Light.
This is what? Yeah, Dying Light 2?
Hey, aren't they owned by
Yeah, this is Dying Light.
Doesn't Square publish them?
They might.
Yeah, it's Dying Light.
Have you played Dying Light, Luke?
Yeah, fucking great game.
It's dope. It's first person. There's red parkour, as we're gonna say.
Yeah, it's like parkour zombie.
Have you played Dead Island? You know what it is.
I wonder how much Dying Light 1 would be. I would totally play that again.
I still have the PS.
Oh, no, I do too. I mean, as far as like if Luke ever like decided to get it.
Yeah, I would play that game. Yeah, it was fun.
Disc and then you just put digital.
Good.
And like, all this first person shit felt really good.
Yeah.
It was like amazing because the first game that I felt like ass.
even the expansion pack where we got the car.
Yeah, which we never finished.
Remember when that Kim Remember when that Kim joined our game and streamed that took his sword?
Yeah!
he had like a katana with like a butane torch in the bottom of it, so he made like a fire sword, and he was being kind of a shitty kid. So
I said, oh, excited for this, yeah, me too.
Show me something powerful. We're going behind the picture frames.
That was green. It's gonna be the Hulk.
Two celebrated comics! Finally come once!
A bunch of games that look exactly the fucking same! China Romance, whatever the person's name was.
Dragon Quest 1.75 Final Mix Edition!
Another dragon was guarding cartoonish treasure.
If the collector's edition comes with a real dragon for only $5,000! You have to sell your house!
Oh, our choice is mad, I guess.
Uh-oh. Wait a moment to close it.
I don't think I will.
Featuring Keanu Reeves.
but it's not a cartoon, it's actually like him. And it's like...
It's like just a JPEG of him.
It's like really jarring.
So is this like a 16-bit game or a 3D game? I can't tell.
Why not both?
Brian, I can't tell anything that's fucking happening in these games.
Which game is
weird?
Dragon Quest?
Oh, I need to wear a really pink clothes. Oh yeah, this is a great fucking one.
I mean, this is the old game they did.
Yeah, I'm not about this.
Imagine taking Sony's spot, this is what you bring.
I mean, I'm sure there's plenty of people hyping out a lot of
people, man. I don't know, they keep going to the crowd and nobody seems to give a fuck.
Nobody there cares.
I mean, I am.
Yo, imagine
the I'm waiting for the Iron Man helmet to open. It's just yo.
Yo, imagine that he just pans back and Yoshimaru is being beat the fuck out of a guy in a banjo outfit, and he's just getting killed by banjo.
I gotta get the shit out of here. Let's go. Oh yeah, we gotta definitely go for the screen.
What a sick shot.
Fucking terrible.
There's a few more frames left. I think there's more than at least one.
Yeah, you're a frame.
Final Fantasy Brave Exvius.
How many fucking Final
Enjoyed
Fantasy
by fans
things?
The world over. Has
is it a card game?
39 million
is this
downloads.
A goddamn card game?
Now, Square Enix proudly presents the international reveal of a new title born from the FFB
universe. It's gonna be a card game. Dude, it's gonna be a card game.
War of the Visions, Final Fantasy Brave Exvius.
Reloaded
these two
Definitive
titles,
Edition
FFBE
S3,
and War of the Visions, will be the pillars of the growing
the
world
of
Lapis.
Oh my god, shut the fuck up.
This is the story of Ardora, a continent of Lapis.
Honest,
a tiny spark
Every
here ignites the flames that would embroil the entire
stuff.
Continent in conflict.
Like, they all look like shit.
A conflict later spoken
of
as the War
of
the
Visions. Oh, I need to buy this. Buy. With their parents' credit card.
But what five-year-old's gonna play this?
Leonis, ruled by the Red Lion Monarch, possesses the power of visions, as well as twin princes.
The
Great Western Kingdom, governed by a policy of peace,
and
its brave and wise
king. I don't give a fuck about these fucking factions. Well, they're trying to be Game of Fucking Thrones. Who gives a shit?
Where the King of the Savages has organized the barbarian tribes into Ardora's mightiest militant state. Wezzet, the Great Eastern Kingdom, over which reigns its icy despot.
That goes
in Crystal Sanctum, a religious city-state with believers throughout art.
I mean, how do you live in the ice realm and not have a
God.
Fucking beard? You suck.
Let each burden with its own dignity. Thus is the curtain drawn on a struggle in which
the
fate of nations rests.
This literally looks like Final Fantasy Tactics.
All
like, with
is for
graphics.
One's homeland. War of the Visions, Final Fantasy, Brave Exvius.
Your name has way too many.
Now in development.
Oh, it's not. It's in development. Who gives a shit?
A mobile game. At least make it coming out sooner or now.
Next.
Back to the picture frames.
Nope.
Okay.
That's strange for this conference.
Woke up in the morning, it's a long road.
You were better when you were just Square Soft. Something.
Why did you buy Enix and ruin the company? Did you see his pan then?
All the carnage in back on
just like the little shake.
That I'm about to get all from Robin Thunder.
Oh man, trekking to the Vietnam jungle, 1969 is really cool. Thank you for that. Just got this can of boobs left.
What is this?
That's the thing.
You don't have an ad.
Destiny 3. What?
Square is publishing it.
Outriders.
That's cool, new game.
I'm yeah, no, I'm with that.
Wow. Coming to your mobile device. God damn it!
I hate CG trailers. I'd rather know what the gameplay is. This is gonna be a fucking card game for all I know. I mean, I'm not wrong.
You're not.
Yeah. It's fucking games like this shit.
That's the second one in a fucking year and a half. Who gives a shit?
That shit is on Xbox. Play sucks.
Please welcome Sebastian Wojciechowski, studio head.
Sebastian.
People can fly.
Bonk, bonk. It's Yoshi.
All right. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Outriders is our
I'm
new
Sebastian
card game.
Studio head that people can fly.
Square Enix
studio behind
is a better
Bulletstorm and Gears of War
Xbox,
Judgment.
Though.
Yeah. No. Any Blizzstorm fans? It has? All right.
This is not good.
Wow. Let me tell you, it feels great to be here and feels amazing to be able to finally announce Outriders.
No one gives a shit!
Please applaud.
I'd like to thank the team at People Can Fly. You guys are amazing.
This is why I can never go to
and I know that some of you are watching this live, even though it's 4 a.m. in the morning in Poland, so make a noise for them, please.
I feel like it's 4 a.m. here because I want to go to bed.
Thank you. Thank you. And of course, Square Enix for the help and support as we work together on this exciting new IP. People Can Fly has grown to over 200 developers and 4 studios across Poland, the UK, and most recently the US. Our most ambitious.
Like they're having a conference.
To present more.
I feel like they need to pad this out really hard.
To present more of our vision, I would like to take this moment to introduce a short video from our game director, Bartek Mita. So thanks a lot. More on Outriders this winter. Thank you.
This Amanda's gameplay footage looks great.
Shooters are in our DNA. It's our passion. And it's what we do.
That was why.
Outriders draws on all our experience from all our previous titles. It's a game we wanted to make for a very long time. We describe Outriders as a dark, modern shooter built with traditional values. By that, I mean we are creating an experience with a strong story that you can enjoy with your friends or on your own. We want to tell a complete story.
This is co-op though.
We are confident we are building a shooter with a powerful gunplay, incredible weaponry, and a hostile new world we want to spend many hours in. It's a game we've had in our heads ever since People Can Fly left Epic Games. Outriders is a 1-2 or 3-player drop-in, drop-out co-op shooter. In our game, you will create your own Outrider and journey across the hostile planet of Enoch in search of the source of a mysterious signal. It's a pretty dark and unforgiving world. And yes, there is a lot more depth to the game, but I can't say too much more right now.
Kamehameha! Give us an Xbox.
Is that purple? Not really excited.
My hope is dead. It's not happening.
Could be somewhere at E3, just not on the conference. It makes no sense to me, but.
Reincarnation is the foundation of our way of life. We celebrate the lives we've been given offer up prayers for the next.
They straight up lied to us.
It is grief of death which shackles the living and causes the dead to stray. Indeed, there is no greater affront to reincarnation.
So we
turn
our
grief to joy. The tweet was made for Saints Row.
As we send off.
Yeah, there was a
Genki.
But the souls of those who held back their tears in life still need salvation in death.
We're coming up on a very super ethical weekend. Like, it's like you're clearly like hinting at E3.
To the Watchers.
I mean, the show's not over, but
the Watchers.
The longer it goes on,
the tie the lost to this world.
I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm gonna lose my
and
shit.
Send them off to the next.
I just feel like it would be weird for them to be at E3, but also not
they
be
navigate the emotions of the living and the dead.
Yeah, right.
They prize life above all else.
Like, based on half the remakes and mobile games I've seen, you couldn't fit Saints Row in here since it's being announced.
This is the story of one watcher.
Does they have some anime games that are all slightly different anime styles? What's your read, Luke? Any of these things doing it for you?
Yeah. Like, half these games I'm not gonna remember.
Oh shit. It's purple. Don't do this to me. Oh no. This might be it. Don't do this to me. Oh.
Oh, this is a Final Fantasy remake?
What the fuck is this? This looks like shit!
No, that's the original gameplay footage. Ah, oh, pretty much.
Oh my god, come on! This looks like dog shit.
My dream is dead.
They remastered the text, everything else looks like ass.
Switch.
Is this game not considered to be a good one?
It's alright.
They literally skipped over porting these to Switch. This one to Switch, I'm pretty sure. Did they end like 7, 8? This is 8, right?
Yes, thanks.
Yeah, they did 7, 9, 10 on Switch.
This is it right now for Switch.
Civilians?
Dude, they run into a purple frame for those who have been waiting.
Fuck.
They got me.
Who's been waiting like that?
Nobody talks about this game.
People talk shit about this game. Constantly.
It's 2019.
Are we up to like 6 Final Fantasy things?
No, probably.
In this conference? Oh my god. Microsoft Flight Simulator.
Not the Avengers.
Yeah.
We're
here.
Yep.
Never meet your heroes.
Wait, end on Saints. We're done. Dude is dead. Let's get me my 1 point. Oh, it's Avengers Day.
Did MCU like this?
The Avengers were everything I wanted.
Hello, San Francisco!
Inspired by, for sure, but
yeah,
definitely not.
Thor, Tony, check it out at once.
Try to
these
keep
look
up.
Like Saints Row character festivals.
This just got a whole lot more interesting.
Oh fuck, here we go.
All the murderers.
Do the Avengers pose a danger to society? That was the question, Bruce. That was the question.
Well,
I'm so fucking hyped for this game.
But that's not how this story ends.
Suit.
Was
like They're gonna bring someone up to talk.
Well, what are we waiting for?
I would imagine.
Thanks for coming by!
Please welcome Sean Eskay, Creative Director, Crystal Dynamics, and Bill Roseman, Vice President and Creative Director, Marvel Games.
There's like custom character hair that's like still.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Come on.
Thank you.
That's a dope shirt.
We love you.
Yeah.
Green Lantern logo on the right. Let's go.
Thank you, everyone. We are incredibly excited to reveal Marvel's Avengers to the world.
Left guy.
Let me get a look at the guy on the right. Let's see.
A few years ago, Crystal Dynamics and Marvel began collaborating on an original Avengers game.
Kind of a little better.
One that combined epic action adventure with cinematic storytelling. A game where we as players can experience in both single player and co-op what it's like to be Earth's mightiest heroes.
Do I have any true believers in the house?
Yes!
Awesome.
Because you will instantly recognize
your favorite superheroes and villains. But you'll also see that they're unique to this game, as this is Crystal's interpretation of these iconic characters.
Our story begins at A-Day, as San Francisco celebrates the opening of the Avengers West Coast headquarters. And the team's custom helicarrier, outfitted with a strange experimental energy source. However, the day turns deadly when an attempt to steal this new technology results in massive destruction. Blamed for the tragedy, the Avengers are outlawed and our heroes disband.
5 years later, a horrific evil threatens the world.
You're illegal.
And our only hope is to reassemble Earth's mightiest heroes.
The Saints.
You'll play as your favorite Avengers in an all-new original story showcasing authentic Marvel heroism and humanity. It's about losing what matters to you most and fighting to get it back.
Well, they can't get the job done. Batman shows up.
Yeah! Yeah!
Most importantly, this is a story about self-acceptance in the face of adversity.
This is the story
about embracing our individual powers and learning that together we are mighty.
You'll lead the team as a legendary super soldier, Captain America. You'll call down the lightning as the Asgardian god of thunder, Thor. You'll channel the anger of scientist Bruce Banner by unleashing the Hulk!
This guy's making
you'll
me sound
that
cool.
You'll gather intel and strike swiftly as the ultimate tactical spy, Black Widow. And finally, you'll blast through the sky as the charismatic Tony Stark. Known to the wider world as the Armored Iron Man.
What? Iron Man.
To bring this incredible story to life, we've assembled an all-star cast. I'll let them introduce themselves.
So, here we are. Avengers assembled.
Who are you people again?
Hi, I'm Troy Baker, and I play Bruce Banner.
Hi, I'm Jeff Shine, and I play Captain America.
Hi, I'm Travis Willingham, and I play Thor.
Hi, I'm Laura Bailey, and I'm playing Black Widow.
Hi, I'm Nolan North, and I play Tony Stark. There's certain characters I don't think you ever have to be talked into.
Yeah.
You know, so we'd like to have you play Tony Stark Iron Man. Yeah, yes. You know, everybody always portrays him as this super confident character. I think it's a mask.
for him. I think he's one of the most vulnerable guys.
I think Bruce is just such a cool character. A lot of people are really quick to bring out the big green, but I think that Bruce is a super complex character. It's fun, and I've never played him before.
What is very relatable about Natasha is she's extremely capable, but she's at the core, she's human. She's surrounded by all of this larger than life stuff, step up to it.
I feel like Thor got really interesting in the last 10 or 15 years. For me, I like where he's kind of landed in the public eye, you know?
One of the things I think is cool about Cap is I never feel like he necessarily wants to be a leader. He accepts that he is. I feel like sometimes the best leaders are the ones who don't necessarily want to be, but they're right for the job.
Having an original story to tell as well, what they've done at Crystal Dynamics is great, so I think everybody's going to be pretty stoked.
The Avengers are at their best when they are all together. But the chemistry
is... Oh, God, you're right.
Right?
Do not shake.
It's like, yeah, I kind of shave over here.
Thanks,
with this
everybody,
right here
for joining us. Can't wait for you to be able to play the game. But right now, you don't have to wait for some exclusive content.
Gameplay.
5 years after a day.
Do the Avengers pose a danger to society? That was the question, Bruce. That was the question.
Did you even check the science? Did you check?
It was a heist. Bruce,
no.
We were outsmarted.
The Terrigen reactor was unstable, and you knew that. You knew that, and you still paraded it before the entire world.
So what? We just give up?
We didn't give up, Tony. We failed. At least I can admit that. No, we failed him. We failed him.
Please welcome Scott Amos, head of studio, and Megan Marie, senior community and social media manager, Crystal Dynamics.
And Megan. Just Megan.
Hello, E3. I'm gonna have to go with Scott on this fight.
Look at you that just, big Amos.
You've just seen a high-level view
who'd
of the cinematic
Megan?
And character-driven campaign
I think
of Marvel's
Megan,
Avengers.
I think Scott has a heart
but
attack.
Launch is only the beginning of this adventure.
Marvel's Avengers delivers a narrative over multiple years with exciting new content released at a regular basis.
Like the Avengers, you and your friends are stronger together. You'll assemble into teams of up to 4 players online where you can master extraordinary abilities, where you can customize a growing roster of heroes and defend the Earth from ever-escalating threats. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. And to make sure everyone comes on this journey with us, we're incredibly thrilled to announce that every new superhero and every new region will be delivered at no additional cost.
Whoa!
That's cool.
Come to Deadpool.
Oh, yeah.
I won't
play. I'm
gonna free.
So our promise to the community is that we won't have random loot boxes or pay-to-win scenarios.
Yeah.
Yes,
this game represents a collaboration across Crystal Dynamics, Marvel Games, I know you're out here, Eidos Montreal, these guys are here, Nixie Software, our new Crystal Northwest studio,
Northwest.
And everyone at Square Enix.
Lights are horrible. Stop showing the people.
So our game is about embracing your powers and living your superhero dreams.
He's got a gun.
We have an exclusive gameplay demo in our booth that will show you more of the core campaign, its original story, and our superheroes in action.
I'm gonna fucking beat that guy.
So, Marvel's Avengers will release worldwide on PS4, Xbox One, Stadia, and PC.
Fuck Switch, I guess.
We got you covered. And we're excited to be partnering with PlayStation to bring some awesome surprises to the PlayStation audience.
Spider-Man, remember Club Day in the week, so we're talk to
including early beta access.
Beta.
And unique benefits
That we'll be revealing in the future.
Spider-Man. The rumor was they were in talks because they had the exclusive Spider-Man
But before
game,
we go,
that they would get like exclusive
We have
skins
one final
stuff.
Glimpse into our world, including when you'll get to play this game.
It's this year.
This is what's next for the Avengers. Thank you, true
don't
believers.
Get your fucking point, man. I swear to God.
What?
When I get a point, the trouble for you.
I know, man.
Progress, Hank.
I have a plan, but it's risky.
Hank, that play. Doesn't look ready.
Come on, Tony, live a little.
Unbelievable. It worked.
The door over there.
It's sort of cute when they're small.
Ah, I didn't doubt you for a second, Hank.
Yep. Hank Pym.
Not really the kind of character I would be hyping. Alright.
You're not gonna show me like more gameplay though?
You wanted to hype me up, so you showed me Hank Pym.
I'm hyped for the game. They kind of didn't show me as much as they could have. They literally didn't show like any game.
It just looks like a game.
Yeah.
You didn't show me why this is like an amazing game. Okay.
They're playing Final Fantasy IX music. It was Festival of the Hunt.
But yeah, I feel like they really could have like. To not see gameplay is wild to me.
I mean, the stuff in the beginning kind of looked like gameplay.
When did it say the date was?
May 15th, next year.
Next year?
Yeah, 2020.
That's a bad call, I think. Now they're going to be competing with Cyberpunk and Last of Us as Game of the Year. You could have been a shoo-in this year. If you would have got your game out this holiday. That kind of sucks. Maybe that's why we didn't see gameplay.
Just like every other conference, I'm just whelmed.
Yeah. I didn't like this.
Yeah,
I didn't like this shit at all.
Too super hyped.
This was worse than
here.
Xbox. This was my least favorite conference.
It was so much like niche fucking Square content.
It felt like we know you want to see Avengers, and we're gonna make you sit through so much fucking niche content. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I wasn't a fan of that.
Suicide.
Nintendo save us! Nintendo save us!
Dude, I mean, Nintendo's gonna crush.
Nintendo's gonna clean up E3 again. That's it. Look at that ass, though. Alright, well, I guess that's going to do it. Any closing thoughts from you guys? Any? Did you like it? Did you not like it?
I mean, it looked like in the beginning of the Avengers thing, it kind of looked like gameplay.
There was a huge showing like flashes of gameplay, right?
Yeah, it looked like gameplay, but like without a HUD.
Yeah.
But also,
yeah.
Like, I need to see if this is a butt on screen console.
Oh!
God.
All right, we're going to close Twitch chat. That's some TOS right there.
Yeah, like, you didn't show me why this game is here. Like, really, you showed me fucking Hank as, like, hype moment? You fucking kidding me?
Ooh.
Dude, if that would have been Wolverine, I would have got a point.
It could have been fucking Ant-Man.
Yeah.
You showed me this, schmuck.
Yeah. Well, that's going to do it. That is a wrap on our E3 coverage. Of course, not going to be here tomorrow for Nintendo, but we will be watching. We'll talk about that this week on the podcast, as long as wrapping up everything else for the conference. So that's going to do it for us. Thank you for watching if you're still awake, because I barely am after that shit. So we will see you guys later.
Later. Bye-bye.